Well, the temperature on Thursday expected to be in the mid-90s, but it could feel as hot as 110 degrees in some parts of Minnesota.
So what exactly is the heat index? Good question. Heather Brown joins us now. Of course, Heather, the old saying is it's not the heat.
It's the humidity.
Correct.
Yep. So our friends in Arizona might not always agree with that, but we're here in Minnesota where it can get pretty darn sticky.
What does 110 feel like?
Nothing good.
Pain.
A sauna.
Mm-hmm.
A living, moving sauna.
Exactly, like a sauna.
Thursday's temperature reading will be a little misleading.
So it's like the summer version of wind chill.
A little bit, yeah, because we always talk about that being a feel factor.
Heat indices peaking at 110 degrees.
Wind isn't involved with this per se, but it's a similar effect on how we feel versus just looking at the thermometer.
To determine the heat index, you need to know the air temperature and relative humidity.
How do you calculate the heat index?
It's a big, long mathematical formula.
I mean, look at this guy.
There it is. HI equals minus 42.379 plus 2.049.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Can you believe I had to do that in college?
I want to see how it feels like 110 degrees here by the lake.
Bring your water bottle.
I will.
When we say 110, we're talking about the shade.
Yes.
Yeah, you can really feel the difference.
What could it be like in the sun?
Oh, you know, maybe approaching 120.
That's when the National Weather Service says heat cramps or heat exhaustion is likely.
That all has to do with the human body's ability to evaporate sweat off your body. The more humid the air is, the tougher it is for that evaporation to occur.
We can't ever cool down.
Yes, we feel bottled up.
People always assume it's the sweat that's cooling your body, but really it's the energy released as that's evaporating off your body that gives you that cooling sensation.
Well, if I was on vacation down in Central America, South America, I would feel it was bliss. So I try to visualize kind of being in a tropical land, maybe putting on a little bit of salsa.
Sure like where her head is at there. Now, if you think Chris is toiling away back in the weather center, writing out all these calculations on a napkin, not the case. These days he has charts and computers to figure out the heat index for him, Frank and Amelia.
Well, something happened years ago because he definitely has blown a circuit, and I think it was that mathematical formula that did it, Heather.
Yeah.
All
Thanks,
right.
Guys.
Thank you.
If you have a good question, you can email it by going to WCCO.com/links.